Great. So, I will be here today reviewing Joe Money, shit, JoJo's clip on whatever, fucking Overwatch. All right. So, it's a mid-plat game. See what happens. So wants to play Tracer, understandable. Let me change. All right, yeah, so I wants to play DPS, obviously doesn't want support, which is understandable. He got first pick. I can fill. All right, so let's run Tracer, Hog, Zarya, no Zen, and I think this is a newest patch, which is let me check the date on this. February 1st, yeah, this should be newest patch. But there is still a Mercy, so okay, that helps. Let me go back to that. Fuck. Here you can. With YouTube, you can play frame by frame. All right. So, Tracer, Moira, Lucio. That's meta. Tracer, Hanzo. This is definitely a good dive team. I think the comp looks fine. 100%. And I think the meta for this one would be go. Left side and push all the way in because then they could put pressure on the healers, and usually the tanks, well, Rissa or someone sets up front. All right, let's see what happens. So they didn't really coordinate a plan, which is one mistake. I feel like they should just tie. I mean, they said dive, but should tell where they're diving. Okay, so yeah, they have a Rissa. And they are diving. Okay, I see what Tracer's doing. So they're distracting, but obviously they're overextending. So the tanks can't really do anything when on point. Sure, they get some picks, but I think this. Yeah, they probably win this actually. Yeah, they win this. Huh, that was really well played. So yeah, I mean, it's always good just to like find the other side point so they're looking at the other direction, but the tanks can still jump on them. When you brought them all the way up to the top, it was hard for the tanks to jump, but some people just didn't leave, like Zen or no mobility characters. So it's a good first push. Dive always works very well on this point. Mara just shreds flankers. It's so upsetting. But her coalescence at least will be nerfed. Well, the old charge time. All right, they're looking like a pulse. Again, they're just going off whatever visual cues. Oh, unlucky. Yeah, they're calling out players like who they're focusing, which is good, but it's always good just to coordinate a push. Because sometimes you guys play split. Well, what I do in my games at least is we play split and it breaks up a lot. And it's just not fun. Well, not fun as in we get split out, we're trying to call different targets, but some of us can't reach the same targets. When you call out targets, you want to make sure everyone has sight line of them. Like right now, if you told them Moira's low, no one could really get to Moira. See, half the team's in, half the team's out. It's just unlucky, and that's a form of communication. It's a nice pick, but you lost two in the process, so it'd be hard to go in. If only Valk was good again. Alright, so they have Genji and Sim, Moira, I think. Ooh. Monkey's doing really well pressuring, so now you guys got high ground for free. This is a good idea. Yeah, definitely get that shit. Alright. And they should immediately push in off that, because they just gave up all their point control. The Sim turret's just, yeah. We got. I guess just playing against them, you gotta know where they are and focus those. They're definitely underrated. A good sim knows how to put good turrets. Alright. You got two out of the fight. Oh, what the fuck? My ping shouldn't do that. Oh, what the hell? Am I installing something? Auto 40p? No, I want that 1080p60. No, it seems not open. Interesting. Anyways, I want to say it's been going well overall. Best thing to do is to coordinate pushes and which side. It's as easy as saying, let's go top. And just wait till everyone goes top, and you can flame who doesn't. That's the fun part. So they're going to have sim. The fairy was a good idea. They have no hit scan to take that down. They just got to find turrets, take that down, make sure she doesn't gain any free ult charge. Pharaoh died, so we should just push out there. Pull out. They have shield gen again, so that's going to be priority. It's not really the best idea to be pushing. I mean, sure, it gives you more space to work with, but at the same time, if you lose this fight, then you're just a big stagger. It's just a risk I never really like to do. So your team's now with you, which is nice, but... Okay, big pick. Alright, now they just gotta get shield gen, and then they can win this. Zen was an easy pick, but shield gen's definitely a priority. Picks don't... Yeah, once they come back, they'll instantly have, like, what, 75 HP? Extra? I don't know how much shield gen is. I'm just doing it. Yo, where is it? So they're hiding it better. But as Tracer, I feel like instead of going for picks, you have Pharah and shit to do that. Everyone can focus. Like, five people on point focusing one target is totally fine. But they can't leave. Zen's right side. The switch to Ryan is questionable. If he gets, if he's in barrier and, sim turrets hurt him, he can't really move. I mean, this is just team observations, but, yeah, the Tracer, I feel like, just needs to call out plays, always gonna be a team player, and focus shield gen, of course. It's always hard, but once you, after you got, like, those three picks, I feel like it was just easy to go in. No one was gonna really pressure you. You should just go in, look around for turrets, and free. Monkey's top, and he's low. But yeah, some help would be nice. If Monkey has no jump and he's overextended, you should definitely call that shit out. I was just very unlucky. But it's always good for letting tanks go in first and letting them be the main focus point versus having 150 HP target go in. Alright, so the switch to soldier is never bad. They do have hitscan now, so it's hard for Pharah. And hitscan, just holding top right of this map while the team pushes point is always really good. Because they're going to focus point. The Genji Winston might jump you, but you just jump down and bring them to them. So they're dry pushing, but alright, they're going mid? Unlucky. I always try and shoot rockets at Genji's feet or something whenever they ult. It's that little damage that'll help. That's just unlucky. But yeah, you would have to run from that. That's just a stagger, unfortunately. I would have flamed in that situation. Yeah, Pharah. D.Va just gets shut down. I mean, D.Va shuts down Pharah, but the Reaper, not bad. Maybe a McCree would have been better for the Genji, though. I always like just a flash stun. And whatever, flash headshot. Nice. Yeah, once you saw you couldn't beat McCree, once he had the heal orb on, you should have just ran. You had no team around you, and McCree was going to call you out. It's unfortunate, but yeah, I mean the big thing is you're playing like Tracer, which is kind of understandable since you're just playing like her. But Soldier just excels with team. That's why he has his E, and his AoE healing does really well. Target prioritization, whatever is fine. Okay, that was a nice rocket, nice attempt at least. But yeah, Genji's two swipes and it's annoying. Okay, yeah, so you guys would coordinate. All right, let's go in, and that'd be good. But you gotta current go into who, and you gotta know to prioritize. So like, let's say Monkey would always shove in. So you guys would just be like, all right, let's go in, and then get Monkey instantly. So Orisa's really good on this map. Orisa Torb, of course. But it's like once they dive, Orisa's kind of useless outside shield. She just gets shot. She has such a big hitbox. So it looks like you guys are just trying to counter dive. Anna's good. She's always good. But they were running D.Va Winston last time. So Zen's good at this pick also for that Discord. You just need to stay by a tank, but it looks like they're, yeah. Maybe Lucio is the play here. Yeah, flaming is never, it's just never good mentally after a game. You should always, talk to the team, what went wrong, what they're planning to do, and it just clears their head, gets them in the mood. So usually in this case, I'm like, all right, they had D.Va Winston, so they're probably gonna dive again. So we should coordinate around dive, and then we talk about that. Moira Lucio is just really good, and is getting a higher pick rate, but her win rate's still sub 50. But she's just so fun, I understand. She would really excel under a shield, but if they're gonna run D.Va Winston again, it's just gonna shut you down hard. The beginning nade's never bad, but yeah, Genji can deflect. I would just say, as Ana, I never leave my tanks, because they're the only ones that can defend me from flanker. That positioning's good though, staying on the left. Monkey just went in for free. Okay, so yeah, I mean, like I said, you should just stay by someone. Anna, if you miss your sleep or your nade, you're just fucked. Sure, you can do like a couple hundred damage, but once the tanks come at you're dead. Now, sleep at random points like that, it's never really a good idea. You should always save your sleep for something you know you can hit, or something that's good. Let's say Monkey's walking in, or D.Va's walking in. She's at DM, free sleep. Like right there, perfect. It's always good to capitalize off of sleep. You don't want to just sleep someone in the middle of the crowd, because they're just going to get woken up. No one can one-hit kill from super far away. But free sleeps are the best. Like Hog hooking someone, I would always sleep them. Or Hog, someone getting hooked by Hog, always get them asleep. One thing you should always do as Anna, in my opinion, is if you're scoped in, you should stay scoped in fire. It takes longer to scope, unscope, shoot, well, scope, shoot, unscope, shoot, than it does just to hold down M1 while scoped in. I usually do that for a couple shots, at least four. And that D.Va is just dumb, but should have been called out. Alright, for this point in Anna, I like to hide on the right side. I don't think it's winnable at that point. You're gonna be too slow. Junkrat can't make it. Because Monkey might die here. Unless, yeah, Junkrat's gonna go in. Risky play. So usually on second points, that's when they always use ults. Sure, you're gonna get some damage, but yeah. Once my team dies, and once I die, I just don't go back in and I set up for next. So Anna's good for holding back right. Zen's good. Anyone that doesn't have much mobility, back right is really good. Lucio, you want to be, yeah, with team. Stay around D.Va or Winston and hold that speed with them. Now your 10 meter range is not that small. I mean, it sounds small, but like, you can still wall ride pretty well. If you wall ride around these pillars, no one will focus you. Junkrat can get some random shit off you. Oh, unlucky, but yeah, I mean, they just had zoning. It was just, you gotta work around the dive, unfortunately. Team communication would have helped out a lot in that situation, but that's just how you climb in general. It's just communication. Overall, it was a good clip, and yeah, I hope you improve off of it. Thanks for sending it.